So now we know what is torque and now we know what is angular momentum. But what about if we want to find the angular momentum for a system of particles? Now, say suppose these are the system of particles, say M1, M2, M3. Now all these particles, see, this is the system. When they talk about system, this is the system, and this system is rotating with the angular velocity omega about a fixed axis, say O dash. So this is rotating about a fixed axis and the perpendicular distance. Now please keep in mind, when I say about the perpendicular distance, I don't mean this. What I mean is the perpendicular distance. This is the perpendicular distance, this is the perpendicular distance, and this is the perpendicular distance. So this is what perpendicular distance actually means by. So now, angular momentum of for a system of particles, say this particles is rotating about a fixed axis. So if you want to find the angular momentum of this whole system, then the total angular momentum of a system of particles about a given point, say suppose about a given point, say suppose this is a given point, this is my given point, okay? So this is my given point, about a given point of individual particles, that is, we need to add vectorially the angular momentum of individual particles. So suppose if we need to find the total angular momentum of this whole system, we need to find the vectorial sum of the individual angular momentum of each of these objects of mass m1, of mass m2, and mass m3. So how is this possible? Say suppose this is L. This is the total angular momentum, L, and the angular momentum for individual is given by L1 plus L2 plus L3 plus till Ln particles. That is how many particles are there. So this is the formula. And this can be written as summation of I equals to 1 to N L of I. So this is the formula. Therefore the angular momentum, if we generalize angular momentum, say for ith particle, somewhere in here we have the ith particle which we can generalize from 1 to n. We have angular momentum L I, which is equal to, as we know, angular momentum is equal to the position vector r I into linear momentum p I. So this is your angular momentum for an arbitrary point I. Now if you further, say suppose if you further integrate, integrate all of this, integrate this whole L I and R I, you will have the angular momentum for the whole system. So now we have, in our previous video, we have seen that if we differentiate angular momentum with respect to time t, we get torque. With respect to time t, we get torque. So if you are taking the angular momentum of ith particle, I have taken the angular momentum of ith particle and I have differentiated with respect to time t, then I'll have torque which is equal to the torque experienced by the ith particle. This is the torque experience or the torque due to the ith particle. So this is how we can write. Now we know that torque is actually equal to what was it? It was R. This is R into force. This is the position vector into force applied. So if I want to take the summation of all the torque that is experienced by all of this system, I can easily write I equals to 1 to n, I equals to 1 to n Ri into F. So this is the torque that is being experienced, that is being experienced. Now further, I know that the total torque is actually equal to force external plus force internal into its position vector, into its position vector. Or what I can understand is that total torque total is actually equal to torque external plus torque internal. Torque external plus torque internal. Now, there is a thing in Newton's third law. Newton's third law, which states that if you push a body, the body itself will push you back. So internally, by Newton's third law, internally, inside the body, without any external help, the net force internally will become zero. The net force, this is external and this is internal. This is R cross internal. So the net force becomes zero. If this becomes zero, then we can say that, or we can assume that the internal torque, this is the internal torque, this is external torque, the internal torque. If the net force becomes zero internally, so the internal torque will have no role to play. This will have no role to play. Now, this particular concept that I'm giving you, I've discussed this in our previous chapters also, that is in the laws of motion. So please see to this how the internal forces gets cancelled out. So now coming back, so the total torque of the system is because due to the external force that has been applied. Since the internal force is zero. Okay. So all now that we have is torque dl upon dt is equal to torque external. dl upon dt is your torque external. Now, if, this is very important, if no external force is applied, what happens if no external force is applied? So when no external force is applied, the torque external becomes zero. Now if the torque external is zero, that means dl, the rate of change of dl with respect to dt is equal to zero. Now if this is the case, if this is our equation that we have arrived, then we can make an assumption, or we can easily say, or we can prove. We can prove that L is a constant. So if no external force is being applied to the system, then there is another statement that we can put, is that there is a conservation of angular momentum. That is conservation of angular momentum. Conservation of angular momentum. So this is what we can conclude from our above equation. So when conservation of angular momentum is there, therefore the system does not lose energy. That is, it regains its mechanical energy. Mechanical energy is intact. So this is the conclusion that we can draw, and this is one of the most important conclusions that you have to remember. So please look into this video carefully and try to understand the concepts. Plus, if you are starting, I advise the students to not to start with this particular video, but go seriously from our previous videos. Only then you can understand the chapter in a better possible way.